So, you have decided to bring a Degu at home and are now thinking about how to house them. It's obvious that you have to buy a cage, get some accessories and toys to create a habitat for them. However, most of the time we get dazed with Degu habitats and guinea pig or hamster ones. But guinea pig or hamster cages are not spacious enough for Degus, as they need large enclosures to jump and run around. If you buy the wrong setup for your babies, then taming them will be a hard job for you. So, we have come up with the complete guide of Degu cage setup ideas for beginners. Therefore, without further ado, let's jump into the video.
Petopedia.
At the very first of a cage tour of Degu, you should know that Degus are very social creatures and need to be kept in pairs of two or more. But with increasing numbers of Degus, the cage size and quantity of accessories will also increase. Though Degus are very friendly darlings, they have the nature of being territorial. Every group of Degus generally has a territory of at least 200 square meters of their own. They use stones, sticks, and dropping for marking the territory. Even they have spacing chambers for doing their functions as dropping, nesting, or storing things. So while housing your Degus, you have to keep these things in mind too. Now, coming to the cage setup, first, you have to buy a vertical cage just like barricades with multiple levels. Even a chinchilla cage or a ferret cage can also be suitable for Degus with some customizations. You have to keep in mind that the cage should have at least a space of 18,000 square centimeters inside for 2 to 3 Degus. With the addition of each new Degu, a space of 4,000 square centimeters has to be added to the current cage. You can also buy another cage if you want to keep the new Degus separated. However, it is better to keep the female Degus separated from males to minimize the risk of community population. Also, it minimizes the struggle of cleaning large cages at once. Another important thing you should also consider about Degu cage is the bar spacing. The space should not be more than 2 cm because Degu squirm their body from those bars and escape away. Though little babies can still escape from 2 cm space, so for Degu babies, consider more close bar spacing. Adding to that, the flooring of the cage should be a solid surface, as wire mesh can injure the soft feet of Degus. Also, it's best to use fewer plastics on Degu cages. Degus have a bad habit of chewing things whenever they get a chance. So, it's best to use edible materials such as quin-dried woods on Degu cage. With that, there should be at least 2 to 3 grooved grip labels connected with ladders to climb up. Also, ensure the levels are sealed by side so any Degu can't fall from that, otherwise they can be seriously injured. Furthermore, the bedding should consist of low dust material such as wood shavings, recycled paper materials, hay and straws to enjoy munching throughout the day. If you choose wood shaving, then avoid the cedar and pine boards for safety concerns. Adding to that, you have to accessorize the cage with hideouts, food bowls, water dispenser, a water bottle, dust bowl, blanket and fleece, and a hammock for making the habitat more exciting for Degus. Also, you have to add some chewing toys and an exercise wheel for stimulation. So, that's all with our Degu cage setup ideas for beginners. Hope this video quenches your curiosity about the Degu cage setup and you will like to create the best habitat for your Degus. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and share this video with your friends if you find our videos useful. Be sure to subscribe and press that notification bell for more updates in the future.